Welcome to Hops News, the trusted source in beer culture news. Here's your host, Jay Brew, with special guests, the Hoppy Mommy, Lucky, and Nash.
Hey, welcome back to another episode, and I'm going to apologize right now. My voice is trashed still after this past week. For anybody that was following along, or I guess we really didn't do much, I'll be honest with you, towards the end of the weekend when the weekend with Lucky and Big Daddy from Feeling Lucky was winding down, we sat around and drank a beer and kind of closed up Boonshine on Sunday evening, and we come to realize we really didn't post shit that we were doing, so definitely.
You know, you're enjoying life, man.
Yeah, definitely could have done a little bit better job with that. But what I will tell you guys is Thursday, I think I talked about it Wednesday, Thursday was a home game for App at Bank of America in Charlotte. Never met Big Daddy, also known as Marty, from Feeling Lucky. He's recently moved down here south and lives in Greenville, South Carolina, only about 3 hours from me here. Talked him into meeting me there in Charlotte for the football game. I think I pulled into the parking deck there at Bank of America to start tailgating at 11:31. By 11:32, I had my first beer open and was well on my way to being a painful morning. Needless to say, what was that?
What took you so long?
Yeah.
This man was cracking it open in the little holder as he's rolling in the parking spot. Back.
Yeah, it was a good morning. It was pretty interesting. Charlotte, downtown Charlotte, is kind of dead from what it used to be with everybody moving out of the big cities and working from home still. But had a great game. Needless to say, App won. We obviously, when you're the winning team, you want to stay and gloat in the parking lot a little bit. And probably did that a little bit too long, and I didn't roll into Blowing Rock, my driveway, until about 2:30 in the morning. And my fucking alarm went off at 5 o'clock, and I wanted to throw that fucking thing across the room.
Calling in sick today, fam.
Yeah.
Absolutely not.
Yeah, for sure. I wish I could have. But got up like a trooper, went to work, and Saturday was on again. Luke Combs was coming to town. Anybody that's a country music fan, I'll show a video here in just a minute to give you kind of the idea of what Luke Combs and Boone was like. Luke Combs was coming to town. This concert was literally, 2 years in the making. Originally scheduled for the COVID, May of the beginning of COVID, and obviously postponed, I think, 4 times until he finally put it on this past Saturday. Marty came back up again, and Lucky Nick came back or came up that time. Actually flew down from Wisconsin that morning. Marty picked him up in Greenville, South Carolina. They came up here. We started drinking, and I was drinking well before they got here. But man, we had an absolute ball. And I'm not much of a music fan. I mean, I can't tell you any, you know, who sings what, or I didn't know the words to his songs or anything like that. But Lucky and Marty are pretty big fans. Those guys sang along to every song that he sung, and the stadium was absolutely. What's that?
Oh, we lost
you
for a minute.
Second.
You froze.
Oh,
for
did
a second
I?
There.
Oh, sorry about that.
It's like but after your climactic note, and that was it.
Yeah, absolutely had a ball. I'll show you.
Me or not.
I'll show you a quick video that Luke just tweeted just about 10 minutes before we started here. I hope it works. I think I've got it downloaded and everything to work. We'll show you guys here in just a second.
My ears.
I was going to say, I can tell Matt's excited.
Put this away.
I love country. Turn it up.
This show is a long time in the making for me. I attended college here at Appalachian State University. I taught myself to play guitar 10 years ago in the town that we're in right now. I wrote the first song that I ever wrote in this town. And tonight, I'm playing my first stadium show in that same town where I taught myself how to play guitar. It's real hard to believe.
There's a couple people that I owe a beer to. Three or four, I owe more than a few.
So it was a great, great show. If you guys did watch it, these guys couldn't hear it on this end, but it was his first stadium concert. First stadium concert at Kid Brewer, and there was 35,000 people in Kid Brewer in a town that's only the population of 13,000. So an absolutely spectacular show. Had a great time. Lucky, and if you haven't listened to the podcast that those guys put out on Tuesday, go and listen to that. Kind of gives you day by day, blow by blow. Up here, we ended up doing some golf, recording the episode. At Boonshine, and had a good time. So go check out those guys' episode. We've got some great guests tonight. Gonna be extra special, and it's Beat Miami Week in Boone. So
bullshit.
I mean, that's not very hard. We just watched what Alabama did. They played.
Alabama spanked us, man. But it's still all about the U.
So with Beat Miami Week, let's go check in with Hoppy. Let's go check in with Hoppy down in Orlando, and let's get a temperature of the Florida weather. Hoppy, I know it's going to be balls hot in Miami on Saturday.
Likely, yeah. Did he cut out again?
No, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes. Okay. Yeah, the weather today, let's see, it was really hot, and then it rained, and then it was gross and humid, and then it rained again, and then it was nice and cool. So you never know what you're going to get. But I do have, so my dad actually gave me this can this weekend. And so Jay Wakefield Brewing, which is an amazing brewery down in Miami, they always do a thing every year right before UM season starts, and they've done the Turnover Chain beer. They've done Stomp, you know, or was it Drain the Swamp beer, and it was like they, because we were playing UF, and they even were like serving Gator Tail at the party. So the original can, they didn't actually sell it because they didn't have permission to sell like stuff that was actually from the college, but my dad managed to get a can and gave it to me, and it says Turnover on it. Turnover chain.
That's man.
Embarrassing. You're down 49 and you break out a turnover chain. That's embarrassing.
Oh my God. The worst part was earlier in the game when they got a turnover, and then the turnover got turned over, and the poor kid had to take the chain off. It was so sad. Oh, and then, yeah, my alumni at FAU got spanked by the Gators. It was a terrible day for college football.
At least your team didn't lose a 21 point lead.
Oh, yeah, against UCF. So, haha, at least they won. And I did. I actually had beers at Ellipsis Brewing on the day that UCF beat Boise, and they have a national like a self-proclaimed national championship UCF banner there. So they're big here that they won. Well, I forget what year it was, but whatever. But I'm drinking a beer from Micah, actually, from Solace Brewing. It's a very nice, juicy double IPA at 8.5% with El Dorado, Simcoe, and Mosaic hops. And it's delicious. Micah has figured out the beers I love, and he sends me all the juicy, delicious cans. And I got my Bottleshare shirt on, so I'm ready to go.
Very nice. So, Hoppy, I couldn't resist. I didn't plan on going to the game until yesterday. Somebody texted me and said, hey, man, you coming to the game? I got an extra ticket. My answer was no, but I could be convinced pretty easily. Searched the tickets, found a ticket for $176 round trip to Miami from Charlotte. And
dude,
I booked.
Wow.
Dude, that was how much my Chicago flight was round trip.
Yep.
Yeah, that's good.
Booked my room today, so I'll be in Miami to watch App State whoop the dog shit out of Miami in their own backyard.
Ben bonito, Miami. No, it's all about the U. We're going to be at home, so yeah.
It'll be fun. No, I'm looking forward to it.
At home crying.
Most definitely, Mash. Most definitely. Let's go check in with Mash. Mash, how are things going in Mountain Home, Idaho?
Well, things would be going a whole lot better if my Chicago trip didn't get canceled.
So what?
That was awesome. I was going to go see the love of my life, Aaron Rodgers, throw touchdowns in Chicago once more before he breaks my heart and departs the Green Bay Packers for the Denver Broncos or whomever next year. So,
what happened with that?
Things are fine. I'm fine.
Wait a minute. What happened? Wait. What happened with that?
Well, there's a little thing called COVID on the rise, and the military was like, hey, guess where you guys aren't going? And since they pay my bills and I'm bound by the UCMJ, I get to, you know, for the second year in a row, my birthday weekend has been reduced to atoms and sadness. So that's okay. I'm 30. I'm about to be 31 now. So really, birthdays don't mean anything. But my heterosexual life mate and I, we're about to go and drink a lot of beers in Chicago, explore the Chicago beer scene. Poppy was maybe going to fly out. We were maybe going to do our 100th episode together.
Well, not now.
Brewitch might have been there. Who knows? But you know, things.
TBD.
But I have airline credit now, so I'm waiting for Brad to kind of get his life together so we can go to the common law opening in Nashville. And other than that, though, things are good. I'm drinking an actual Chicago beer from Microphone Brewing called Raindrop Drop Top. You know, the well-known song we might know. And on a heavier note, I'm rocking the Definitive Beanie because, as everybody knows, they're like my all-time favorite beer out of Portland, Maine, my home stomping grounds. And their head brewer slash founder passed away unexpectedly the other day. So gotta represent them. They have a GoFundMe out. Go check out their Instagram page and anything that you can help out his family, help them out.
Which brewery?
So, Definitive Brewing.
Okay.
They're in Portland, Maine, in Kittery, Maine. So I'm from Boston originally, and that was like one of my favorite places to go and hit up beers before I moved out this way. And so they're relatively new. They just celebrated their third anniversary, and he started at Mass Landing. Dylan did. He was their head brewer, their first head brewer at Mass Landing. Then he moved, I think it was Austin Street, and then he went over to Definitive. So he's a pretty big staple in the Portland beer scene, which is a pretty good beer scene. And so,
yeah,
with that said,
this summer actually.
Yeah. Oh man. Oh God, I love it. I haven't been home in 2 years, but soon, because it is the best time of year, fall. In case anybody didn't know, we're in spooky season.
Oh, you like
we're
fall?
Full on spooky season.
I
got my Hello Gorgeous candle, pumpkin. It smells delicious, ready to go. I got my pumpkin beer I brewed this weekend. It is fermenting currently. So, yeah, we're rolling along, man. And if Chris can't make it, I'm the bottle share team tonight. Just saying.
Yeah, I was going to say, I was just going to ask you, because I'm going to have to rearrange some windows here for a minute. And
I'll hit them up real quick to see what the status is. But if not, then, you know. That's my side hustle, man. You know, we all got a side hustle, so that's what that is.
All right, let me know what you find out. Let's go check in with Brew up there and Brew. Why do I have your name wrong again on here? I've got you back in Germany, and you're not in Germany yet again.
It's fine. It doesn't matter. Like, I would be happy to be back there, so I'll take it. Yeah, no, things are going well. I have not been up to too much since the last time I talked to you guys. I went to a big beer fest here in Chicago.
Got hit in the head pretty severely. I feel like that's up.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, like so. I have like a teensy concussion, so I haven't really been drinking much for a few weeks. But I'm in the clear now, it seems. So I'm having a beer today. I'm actually having one from Mash, The Edge of Rainbows. I don't know, my
Woodland, yes.
Hey, Woodland.
Yeah, can you see it?
Yes.
My camera, I'm very pixelated on my screen for some reason. But yeah, so it's Edge of Rainbows. It's a hazy IPA with pineapple added, Woodland Empire. And it's a collaboration with the Boise Radio, which I thought was pretty cool.
Oh, yeah.
Radio Boise. It is a hazy IPA with pineapple, which I was a bit wary of because pineapple is not my favorite. But it's actually lovely. I know. There's something about pineapple that sometimes it's too much for me, but it's actually very nice. Like, it is a thick old, like, you can see, like, pineapple-y things happening. Delicious. It's very thick. It's good.
Pineapple-y.
It's very good.
There's some things that are happening pineapple-related.
Official beer talk happening here. Thank you. So, yeah, otherwise, like, I've been super laying low for a few weeks. The last big thing I did was going to Beer Under Glass, which was so fun. It was also boiling outside, so I only lasted like an hour and a half before I bailed, but it was very, very good. And I tried loads of beers. I tried Microphone while I was there. I had, I think it was an Italian Pils, is what they said. So I had that, and I tried a lot of other things. My favorite thing I tried was some sort of like, it was like a rosé sour ale from Hopley, and it was good. It was just good. So yeah, that's what I've been up to. Otherwise, outside of this, the only beer I've had in the last like 2 weeks was a fest beer from Maplewood in Chicago, and that was phenomenal. That was one of the best ones I've had in a while. So yeah, that's what I've been up to.
Sounds like you've been busy, Brew.
So busy doing nothing for 2 weeks. Yes. It turns out when you have a concussion, you're supposed to avoid screen time, which is hard as hell. So like,
That's just
amazing. I know. I think it is, because a lot of people seem to disagree with that theory, but like, I did it for like a week, and that was hard. It was a lot.
Yeah.
So, but I'm back at it now.
We're all addicted.
Binging things left and right.
Yeah, for sure. That had to be rough. So what caused it?
I mean, I wish I was. When I was talking to the doctor about it and I told him what happened, he was like, yeah, you need a better story. Like, all that happened was that. Yeah, that's what he said. And I was like, cool. So, like, all that happened was, like, a rug just slipped out from under me. That's all. And, like, I fell towards a wall.
Look, and I broke my arm tripping over my feet once, so you're totally good.
Yeah. Yeah, like, it just.
Fellow in there, you'll be good.
Yeah. I need to come up with something better soon, because every time anyone asks, it's just this. Okay, got it. I'll take it.
Yeah.
You were saving some puppies.
Yes, I was, yeah. We all know it.
Well, we're glad you're back.
I see
glad
you're, has joined us, and she's probably like in the middle of our conversation, like, what is happening here?
What's up, Emily? Giant pain in the ass. But it's great. Great. Love it.
Getting concussions.
Being on this show is like saving
puppies. Yeah, getting concussions, 100%.
Emily, are you in Denver yet, or are you coming up tomorrow? You can't come. You're always welcome. You know.
Jay, did you leave? Is Jay?
No, I think I've got Chris
on
here.
Oh, there's Chris.
Let me get Chris set up here. Yay. Just a minute. I started to take it down and reassign it, but we'll get him set up. We'll get you in here in just a second, Chris. Matter of fact, I got you on your own. There you go. Chris Defer John, founder of Bottleshare. Welcome back to Hops News, sir.
Oh, man. I can't tell you how thankful I am to be here.
You're looking good, man. You look real good.
Yeah, your video's better than all of ours.
Yeah, honestly.
You got a nice pontoon shirt going, man. You got the flow going. The beard's looking real good.
Lighting
man.
In the background.
Beautiful as ever.
God, we're here for it.
I appreciate you guys. I swear, I need to be on here more often. You guys do wonders for my ego.
Hey, we're here for you.
How's everybody doing?
Great.
We're living our best
We're ready
lives.
To hear about this collab you guys got coming up.
Yes. Oh, boy. It's only the greatest collab in the history of collabs. I don't know if you...
I think Jordan's drinking it already.
But it's a good one.
Is that what's in your glass, Jordan? Because it looked really good.
I don't know how this works. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. Yes, it is.
You always go the wrong way first. It doesn't matter what you think you're doing. It's always... But that
looks it's always going to be wrong.
You can do this for 2 years and still have no idea.
Well, let's put the whole crew on the screen here. We've got Christopher John with Bottleshare. We've got Jordan, the founder of Woods Boss Brewing. Going to talk a little bit about the collaboration that they're doing with Bottleshare. And I'm going to sit back here and finish my pipe and this beer. Happy, I'm drinking one of your beers that you sent that I finally got from. Go here and show it real quick. Go here and show it real quick.
That was our guest, Big Rick.
3 years ago.
Yeah, Big Rick. Man, that was a guest, too. We need to get Big Rick back on sometime. That guy was a lot of fun. So I'm going to sit back and enjoy it and run the show on this end, and let's have a conversation about the collaboration going on.
Can you add Emily, too, from Radcraft?
I don't have any of that made up. As you can see, there's graphics and everything that we've got along with the show, so I don't have any of that made up, but she can be a part of the conversation for sure.
All good. Emily will be a disembodied voice.
She's like Jarvis.
Let me make sure that we can hear her on the live. And there we go. She should be good to go now.
Are we gonna have Emily on here?
She's here.
Dude, I am stoked.
You got the whole crew,
you know,
Christopher.
Everybody comes out when Chris is joining. Everybody comes out. That's how you know it's a party, man.
I don't know about that. I don't know about all that. So I think it's Jordan. Honestly, I think it's Jordan Fink.
I mean, he has the goods. He's got the goods in his hands that we are all interested in hearing about.
Let's
collaboration. What's going on? What is it? Let's do this.
Sure. So I met Chris a bit over a year ago now, maybe a year ago, I don't know. Dude posted up on one of the industry Facebook pages saying, "Hey, I'm coming to Denver. Who wants some meat?" And I didn't know who he was. I was like, "Yeah, come on by." And he shows up, and it turns out to be Chris from Bottleshare, which I'd heard a little bit about, and it turned into a, like, three-hour drinking, sharing personal story, best, learning about Bottleshare. And for those of you who don't know what Bottleshare is, I'll let Chris tell that one. But what we got into was the decision to make beer and raise money for Bottleshare. We just didn't know when. So over the course of the next year or so, we kept talking about trying to figure out what the right way to go, when to do it. And about 6 months ago or so, Chris was back in town. We're like, you know what? We just found out TVC is coming to town. Let's do it then. Release this awesome beer, make something cool, and release it during CBC, and that way more breweries, more brewers around the country who are going to be in town can hear a story, hopefully also want to do more collabs all over the place and raise money for folks that are having a fucked up hard time that are part of the industry. We actually were honored to be able to work with Bottleshare just a couple months ago. A good friend, brewer here in the Denver scene, you know, lost his wife to breast cancer. She was young, couple of young kids, and working with Bottleshare, we were able to raise about 20 grand to help him out through, you know, one of the worst, most fucked up, traumatic times of his life, and that was awesome. So while we were talking about it, this was really funny. I don't know if you know this about Chris, but he likes to cry. Very much.
He likes to cry.
He does.
Same, baby. Honestly, like me too.
No, it's great. So we're sitting there shooting the shit about making this beer. We're like, all right, we're gonna do it. What do we want to do? And he happened to show me a picture. I'm gonna see if I can get it right this time.
Other way. There we go.
There it is.
There we go.
Showed me a picture of his brain. Right, he just had a recent brain scan done, and I was like, "That's a label." He's like, "What? No, really?" I was like, "Yeah, of course." And then talking about it more, and I'll get into the beer in a second, but just more of the background story. When we were talking about making a style, we're like, "All right, what's a beer that we can sell the shit out of and raise a bunch of money and folks will really dig?" Figured to be in the IPA world, and I'm just fucking tired of making hazies all the time. We have to make a lot of them. A lot of people drink them, and they're great.
Hide your ears.
Don't get me wrong.
I know. No.
Lauren's our haze bro of the group, so cover your ears.
Well, no, I mean, we have 5 hazies on out of 20 taps at any one time. So
sometimes it was a lot.
I'm not bashing hazies. I just wanted to do something different. So we figured we'd make a clear but juicy IPA. So more of a, yeah, there it is. More of a West Coast style, but the way we mess with our water in terms of salt additions, the hops we chose, and how we use them was more of that juicy, hazy influence as well. So it's sort of one of those East meets West sort of deals. But I don't know if you can see.
That is pretty clear too.
Very clear. My camera's not doing great.
That's great.
I like that glass too, man. That's pretty nice glass.
Oh, thanks.
Yes.
The Monique, I don't know.
I can never pronounce it.
Chris, your brain looks like a lionfish.
Yeah, you know what? You're not the first person to say that. it's pretty funny. So this is the brain scan right here, and essentially, can you blow that up? Can it get any larger at all?
Yeah, I'll try. Just a second. You want to talk just the brain, right?
Oh, wait. You know what? Well, I'm looking at it on my laptop here now. It's popped up. It seems to be large enough. There's two white arrows that point down into sections of the brain. Now, those two arrows indicate the atrophy of my brain. And so there's no activity there. Those sections of my brain are completely dead and will never grow back. And that is kind of what we were looking for at the beginning when the accident had first happened. We couldn't figure out what the problem was and what was causing all of my issues. So I had a MRI done within about 4 months of the accident, and they had, you know, they had told us that there was atrophy of the brain, but we didn't get images quite like these. So two or three years later, we decided to get a second MRI just to confirm what the first had said. So not only did we find the two areas of atrophy, but we also found some white matter lesions growing on the brain. And that's kind of a, you know, to touch and go kind of situation with something like that. So come December, I'm going to have a third MRI, and we'll be able to tell if the white matter lesions are either growing in size or multiplying. And either one of those could be bad news bears, but, you know, nothing's ever going to stop me from doing what I do, and this is what I do, and I absolutely love it, and I'll take it to the grave with me.
Dang, man, you're about to make me cry.
God bless. Jesus.
Yes, you finally did it. Matt's finally crying.
I've only ever cried when Superman said Martha. And that's the last time I cried, I think.
I cried too, tears of sadness. You cried tears of like, oh, this is amazing.
No, but seriously, man, I love that you use that for this. The name and just matches perfectly with the, like, everything kind of flows together. The beer, if we looked at it, it's very clear, kind of like that clarity like we were talking about, and it doesn't look like it's a normal hazy. So.
Yeah. So it drinks like a hazy, but it looks like a West Coast, which is freaking awesome, and obviously. I'm still in Atlanta. I fly out to Colorado tomorrow.
Dude, I'm super good.
And then, Mesh, are you going to be able to make it?
I'm not because of work this time around, so I can't. Okay. But maybe if we do something out this way, or we work a little bit in advance for the next time, I definitely want to get down there for at least one of these to cover it, and then also just to finally meet up with you. I mean, we've been working together for how long now, and so
being able
to finally link up and get together and share a beer and have some good laughs, man.
Couldn't agree with you more, man. Absolutely. And you were dead on about the beer and especially the name Clarity Through the Haze. Jordan had come up with that, and I knew as soon as he said it, it was spot on.
Yeah, perfect.
You know, it really is. It's a direct representation of how my brain works these days. It's often very, very hazy and a lot of confusion. A lot of frustration and stuff like that, but there are moments of clarity, and those moments are really what I hold on to, and give me hope for the next few moments of clarity that will soon come. And this beer is a direct representation of that, and I absolutely love it. And I couldn't be more thankful for Jordan and Ryan and Chad and the Woods Boss crew for putting this together and really really helping us continue to cement our convictions as we chase manifest destiny, right? We're starting on the East Coast. We're working towards the West. I feel like I'm going to be a Sooner here pretty soon in Oklahoma. So I'm going to go out there and mark my territory. No, but seriously, we couldn't be more grateful for the Woods Boss crew and them doing this, especially with the timing, CBC. They've got a lot going on. They didn't have to do this. They didn't have to time this out the way that they did, but they did. You know, and that's the really cool thing about this industry is that there's just so many people out there that want to help, that want to give back, especially now that we have, we're beginning an institution that's going to revolutionize the way that we care for one another in the craft beverage industry.
Yeah. I feel like, too, with the name, real quick, the name, you know, Clarity Through the Haze and how you see clear, over the past 2 years, everybody's kind of had that haziness. from everything going on. So not, it speaks to you on a really great level, but not to get like too deep, or you know, maybe we'll see where we go tonight. But it's also one of those beers that can speak to everybody. It's like, man, you're right. Like, you've had this clarity through this moment, and then with the pandemic and everything, people losing jobs, things like that. It's like, wow, this kind of speaks to me on this kind of level with what I'm going through personally.
See, and that's often you're right. It's universal. You know, we all sometimes have to find that clarity through the haze, and it's not just my story. It's your story. It's Hoppy's story. It's Brew's story. It's Jordan's story. You know, it's all of our stories collectively. And I hope that it continues to, you know, create that thought in other people's minds as well. Wow, there are moments where there's clarity through the haze, and we got to deal with the haze to get those clear moments.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's now, absolutely true.
For those wanting to get a hold of the beer, how far is the distribution going to go? Is it just going to be at the brewery, or are you distributing at local bottle shops, or what?
Well, I mean, if it doesn't sell out through the weekend, then yeah, we'll probably hit some bottle shops, kind of the way things work. I mean, we're a small brewery, right? We're a 15 barrel brew house. I never really wanted to get into canning, but you know, fucking COVID, here we are.
Sure,
not the worst thing in the world. I just fucking hate it. Not what everyone, but there are benefits, right? There are good things. It allows us to get our beer a little bit further out there, introduce ourselves to other people. And, you know, not everyone wants to go to a tap room. They want to get good beer and drink it at home. That's fully respectable. I mean, I get that personally. I live at the brewery. I sleep at home. I don't go to other people's breweries anymore. So if I'm drinking it, it's probably in a can. But to answer your question, yeah, I mean, we're hyper local. The only possibility, and I'll talk to them about it, we work with, what are they called? Beer Drop, who do send beer around the country. And I'll see if I can make a few cases available to them, and maybe get it a little bit further out there. As well, but for the most part, it's, you know, come to the brewery in Denver. If you happen to be in Denver, whether you live or visiting, we have a few kegs for on tap as well, and then maybe a couple liquor stores around town. But my goal is to blast this beer out, raise some money, and get it into Bottleshare's hands so they can get it into someone else's hands.
Definitely. I want to showcase you guys a little bit too, though, because I was looking on your website. For one, your taproom is gorgeous.
Oh yeah,
It's. I mean, whenever I get to Denver, you guys and Lady Justice, those are the first places I'm going.
Oh yeah.
But I want to talk about not just your gorgeous taproom, but you do shadow brewing, so anybody can just join you for a brew day. Can you tell us a little bit about that? Because that sounds amazing.
Yeah, sure. So, this is kind of paying it forward, right? The idea of it. 12 years ago, 11 years, whatever it was, I was a avid home brewer, high school science teacher in between jobs, the beginning of the original Great Recession. I was trying to avoid working in fast food, but whatever. Had just joined my local volunteer fire department and decided that what I really wanted to do was brew beer for a living and hopefully open up a brewery someday. And just started showing up at breweries and asking, you know, can I hang out? Can I help? Can I learn? Can I work? Whatever. I don't think it's a super unique story. But what happened was I happened to roll into Tommy Knocker, OG brewery here in Colorado.
Totally.
Yeah, and I was sitting at the bar with my wife, just finished the hike up in Rocky Mountain, having a beer, talking to the bartender, and I was like, hey, you guys hiring at all? He's like, yeah, I think we're looking for some dishwashers. I was like, no, I mean, like, I want to make the fucking beer. He's like, actually, one of our brewers just, like, gave notice yesterday. This was Saturday. He's like, show up on Monday. Go talk to Steve, who I'd met before, come hounding him. He's like, yeah, I don't really need anyone right now. But I showed up on Monday. He's like, all right, so I am looking for someone. What are you doing today? I was like, nothing. He's like, all right, hang out, brew with this guy. His name was Christian, who started Elevation Brewing Company here in Colorado. Spent the day hanging out with him. Saw Steve at the end of the day. He's like, all right, Christian says you have a clue. Tried your home brews. They're pretty good. What are you doing the rest of the week? Fucking nothing. He's like, all right, come back as much as you want. I'm going hunting. I'll be back next week. I was like, all right, cool. So I show up every single day. Brewed with a guy named Eric Rohde, another legend in the brewing industry, at least locally. He was brewing at New Belgium like 26 years ago or something like that. Helped start Larry Lodge Brewing Company out here, just recently moved back to the East Coast. Brewed with Alex Stansberry, who helped start several other breweries here in Colorado, and has been in the industry for 20 years, and then a bunch of other folks too. Following Monday comes around, and Steve's like, all right, you're hired. Did you bring, you know, I was like, oh, cool. Right on. Like, yeah, the guy said that, like, we like you. Like, I could teach a monkey, so I could definitely teach you.
well, sure. We'll make
it
work. Yeah.
You're like, is that a compliment or right. Whatever? No, don't overthink it.
Yeah, no, it's fine. I was like, I'll take it. So I ended up brewing with them. But, I mean, it was through the ability to just hang out and learn and kind of show them that I was all about it, that I worked it my way into a job. And my head brewer, Ryan, who I met working at Tommyknocker, my second time working there, I'd just come back from Nepal where I helped build the first craft brewery over there with a guy named Charlie Sturtevant, who was one of the owners of Tommyknocker and started Golden City Brewery out here and a few other breweries.
Hey, Jordan, you said Nepal, right?
Yeah, Nepal.
He just subtly dropped that.
Sorry, yeah. I got recruited to go back. I was a teacher. I got recruited to go back in education, and I spent about a year and a half working for a nonprofit here in Denver, working with inner-city kids, helping them get back on track, working with AmeriCorps teams. And after 2 years, even though my idealism wasn't dead, my willingness to continue to work in the nonprofit world was kind of dead at that point. I spent most of my adult life working in nonprofits, and I really wanted to start a brewery. So I figured I could give back in other ways as a brewery owner. Anyway, Ryan, who when I went back to Tommyknocker before starting Woods Boss, that I just clicked. Great guy. But he got his start because he just was showing up and they let him shadow and worked his way into a job. And Ryan and I and Chad, my partner, other owner, used to bartend every Wednesday for the first 3 years that Woods Boss was in existence, up until the point that the pandemic hit. And I haven't been really behind the bar since. Way too busy, and I have a kid and yada yada yada. Hard to be out at night.
Those damn kids, man, they're ruining
yeah, honestly.
They hold me back every day.
I would not trade her for them. I'll tell you that. In any event, like almost day one, you know, being the owners and brewers behind the bar, talking to people, they're like, how'd you get into this? I've always wanted to learn. We're like, come hang out. Come brew with us. And we made a ton of friends that way. People would come, they'd hang out, and they'd brew. We're like, let's formalize this a little bit, and folks who want to know more, who want to be part of it, want to gain some experience, they can come brew with us. So we offer that. It's been a little bit on hiatus during the pandemic, trying to figure stuff out. My goal is to sort of get it back up and running in all the right ways next year, once we've had a chance to kind of breathe, hopefully. We've been working our asses off for a year and a half, just nonstop.
I love that.
I need to get down to Denver. That is awesome. Just like,
you know, I wish Orlando breweries did that
as well.
For real.
Yeah, I don't understand the idea that the brewing is this secret thing that the everyday person.
Super secret club. You haven't heard?
No, fuck that.
Yeah, I don't have a beard. How do I get in?
Yeah, I mean, come hang out.
I can't physically grow one. I wear plaid,
neither
though.
Neither can I.
You don't need a beard. I shave once every month.
All right, let's say.
Because my wife is like, all right, dude.
Me too.
It sounds like a. Sounds like a good time to take a break to talk about some news, some hops news. Yeah, let's talk about some news. So here's a recent label from Flying Dog Brewing Company that was that was denied by North Carolina's ABC. So recently, I think within the past day, Flying Dog Brewing has posted or submitted a lawsuit to North Carolina ABC over their denial of this label. Now, what most people don't know, unless you're in the brewing industry and you ship and distribute long distances, your labels have to be approved by every state they enter. So you take one state out of 30 of them that you submit these labels to that deny it, that can be very expensive for a brewery. So ABC, North Carolina ABC, said it's in bad taste. I don't know what makes this in bad taste, but we're going to have Jim Caruso and his attorney. Jim Caruso is the CEO of Flying Dog Brewery on next week's episode to talk about the lawsuit. So check us out then. It's going to be a should be pretty interesting. I'm sure we'll hear some more movement on it here soon. I've also got a poll up. They're on Facebook. If you're in Facebook, is the Flying Dog label in bad taste? You let us know. I don't think so.
I think
but
it's awesome.
Yeah, I don't see anything wrong with it personally.
I don't know. Yeah.
I mean, it's
your target
it's,
market's 21 and up.
Like, yeah, it's it's Flying Dog label.
Target to a younger kid.
Well, what they're saying is that
it's consistent with their other artwork.
Yeah, what they're saying is the
and
cartoon character is nude.
Affective disorder to go fuck itself. Maybe because they, which you know, I agree with, but maybe the issue is that it's got the dollar sign percentage.
He's not anatomically correct.
Right. I mean, there's no dingle dangle showing.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. Like, he doesn't even have butt cheeks for God's sakes. If we're going that far, so like, good Lord.
Yeah, their issue is that the cartoon character is nude. I don't know how you tell it's nude because it doesn't show anything, but
it's a cartoon character.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, it looks like a Play-Doh creation. Like they're fine.
Yeah, that one with the brown ale and the guy like shitting his pants—that's way worse. And that one seems to get distributed.
I've seen much worse. Definitely.
So that should be a good episode.
Yeah, I've seen way worse about like women.
Yeah, for sure.
Like honestly.
Yeah,
there's a lot of like stuff out there objectifying. So.
There's no objectification here, that's for sure.
It's an odd one. The poll is up on Facebook chat. Go join us there. Hobby, I think you got some beer news as well, correct?
Yeah, I got a couple things. Where did my beer news go? One of the things I wanted to mention, because, you know, we do philanthropy through beer, and so my childhood best friend actually reached out, and I'm going to share the GoFundMe link in a minute. Her husband's in the Navy. They're out in San Diego, and they lost 5 people in the Navy this week in a helicopter crash. All of them left behind families, super tragic, unexpected. Apparently these were like amazingly trained helicopter Navy people. I don't know the full story, but it's really, really sad. They're doing a hashtag 8ballersstrong if you want to know more about it, but I'm going to throw that GoFundMe in there. If you can donate, awesome. If you can't share, if you can't,
make sure
we understand.
You get me their name because I'll talk to you off because obviously I work directly with the people who. I know a lot about this and a lot of survivor benefits off the rails real quick. Get with me because I work very closely with stuff like this. And that kind of stuff.
I definitely will. But I thought it was really cool that she reached out and she goes, hey, I know you guys have a following on Hops News and I know you guys do philanthropy. And like she was my best friend when I was little. I don't talk to her regularly. We just talk, you know, randomly. We'll hit each other up. So it made me very happy that I'm part of this and that she recognized that and that she knows we're doing good stuff. So I was like, hell yeah.
Throw it in the chat.
I love it.
Yeah, I just threw it in the Facebook chat and I'll probably do a post on the socials at some point this week. But as far as beer news, so Coppertail Brewing, which is in Tampa, has teamed up with the Tampa Bay Bucks and they will have 16-ounce can lagers at their games. As well, I know Matt's still a little bitter, as well as 12 packs in the area. I'm loving seeing all these sports teams team up with breweries. My last piece of news is BrewDog has teamed up with Asahi Breweries and now has a joint venture with them in Japan. Asahi is part of Asoka Breweries, and they've been around since 1889. So if you're ever in Japan, you should have no problem getting a punk IPA. And they're also, you know, you can find BrewDog bars in Tokyo, Shanghai, Seoul, Mumbai, and soon coming to New Delhi. So I had no idea they were that international. So that's my pieces of beer news.
I got beer news.
You got beer news, Mash?
I do.
Let's go talk to Mash and get his beer news.
Great Notion, who you might know out of Portland, Oregon, a very, very well-known brewery, has teamed up with the Portland Trailblazers, and they're going to be selling. It's called Ride over at the stadium there. They've teamed up. They're going to be selling Great Notion beer at every single Portland Trailblazers game. I love it because I want to get out there to a game because I'm a big Dame fan, Damian Lillard. Of course, he's probably going to get traded, but this is big because now we're starting to see craft beer pop up in stadiums like this. Like, I know the Washington Capitals have the Devil's Backbone. They're kind of a bigger brewery, but seeing a beer or breweries such as Great Notion sneak into a massive stadium like this, it's pretty good and paves the way for everybody else that's out there.
Nice. Good stuff. I think Brew Witch has got some news as well. Brew?
Yeah, mine's it's a few weeks old now, but basically Guinness is releasing a lot of things. So they're releasing an alcohol-free Guinness, which I mean, they tried to release it about a year ago, but it got recalled due to a contamination problem. So bad marketing anyway. Yeah. But they re-released it as of like the last like 2 weeks, I think. So now you can get your hands on alcohol-free Guinness, and they've also released something called the Nitro Surge. So it's something you can attach to special cans that'll essentially deliver like a draft pint of Guinness. Like, it's like an ultrasonic thing that'll give you like a perfectly creamy pint. So like, if anyone is trying to track one down, tell me because I want to borrow it and see how it works.
The future now, man.
Yeah, I know the future is now. I'm excited.
I want one of those. All right, let's go back to the regular scheduled program.
Hey. So, Chris, Jordan, how much percentage of the proceeds from this beer are going to go towards bottle share and things like that? Talk a little bit about that kind of that topic.
Oh, that's a great question. I'll put that part in Jordan's hands if he wants to answer that question.
Sure. Yeah. I think the last time we talked, we said 50% of all proceeds were going straight back to bottle share.
Yes, that's what I remember. I just didn't want to say it and step on my own foot.
No, here. You're good. Absolutely. So yeah, I mean, you know, we basically did the yield on this was about a 12 barrel batch, and a half of all that going straight to bottle share, which we're really pumped about. You know, normally when we do benefit beers, and fuck, I wish I could give 100%. But we're still climbing out of a pandemic, and we work with a lot of nonprofits, and we try to spread the love as much as possible, but also kind of need to stay in business.
Right.
That's important.
The ugly truth of anything. But in any event, we're pretty excited to be kicking half of this entire batch.
Oh, yeah. We're pretty damn excited as well.
Yeah. So, further to the release, it's on Friday, obviously, as soon as you guys open. I know that there's going to be a few people there covering it. You guys are going live, correct, Chris? Jordan, you guys are going live with full pour. You're going to do the whole thing, front porch. They're all going to be there. Like Tristan, I know he's going to be there. So it seems like it's going to be a pretty big event, right?
We'll see.
Yeah, fingers crossed, man. So
if people show up, it'll be a big event, yeah.
Yeah, the podcast with Tristan is actually tomorrow, so I'm arriving in Denver.
Oh, that's right.
I think my plane lands at like 1:30 or something like that. I'm picking up the rental car and then heading straight over to Woods Boss and setting up and doing the damn thing. So it should be a really good time, and it's going to be great publicity. It's going to raise more awareness, not just for this beer, but bottle share as well. And hopefully get a lot of people in there and purchase the beer, knowing that it goes for a really, really good cause.
Absolutely.
I mean, one of my biggest goals was to have a place during CBC where Chris could post up and hopefully draw people in so that he could make even more connections. You know, that's why this happened in the first place is he rolled through Denver. He was like, hey, I want to meet people. And I'm like, yeah, come say hi. So the more people Chris meets, the more opportunities there are to do things like this.
Absolutely.
It is, I will say, Chris, it is definitely harder. It's easier getting out and talking from my experience, because, you know, obviously I've been trying to get us out here in the Northwest a bit, and travel's been so limited that I feel like it's hard to break through unless you're getting out there and talking to everybody face to face, because you can send emails all day, but that face to face, and especially once they hear your story and just get to meet you as a human being, I don't find anybody who could really say no to an opportunity as great as this one, you know.
Well, thank you so much, man. And it is super important to get out there and meet people and do the whole face to face thing. You nailed it. I could send out 10 emails and not get a single reply, or I could go meet 10 people face to face and bat 1,000. So there's a huge difference there, and it's always an absolute pleasure and an honor, and I'm super grateful for the opportunity to continue to meet more people, because the more people we can meet, the more I can share the story, the more I can share the mission, you know, the more I can talk about, hey, this actually works. You know, we had a goal of granting out $20,000 to people in need last year, in the middle of a pandemic. And I thought that was a lofty goal, $20,000. I was wondering, how the hell am I going to get $20,000 to give to these people? Well, we granted out $124,000. So we beat our goal by 600%.
Just a little bit, right?
Yeah, just a little, barely.
Yeah, just a tad.
But all that is a true testament to the collective character of the craft beverage community.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Absolutely. And I know that she's been sitting here off camera. We can't see her, but I do want to hear real quick, since Emily has been with us, I want to hear about Radcraft real quick, your role, what are you guys, who are you, and plug yourself real quick, since you've been so gracious to sit here and join us.
Emily's the shit is the answer.
I mean, I gathered that already. I like the Guinness attire behind you. Like I said, I can see. I'm really feeling the attire behind. I really want to hear real quick what Radcraft is.
Thank you. I do. I am sitting in the room of OG beer attire, including Guinness and Coors. It's my dining room. And I also, and I think that Jordan is the shit. I was really inspired by his story, as I'm sure that all of you were when you heard it. And he comes from this long lineage or this long pedigree of wonderful breweries and wonderful influence. And so I just really love Woods Boss. I particularly am fond of their connection to craft malt and that community. And I really love the way that Woods Boss puts itself out there to make space for all of the community members of beer. And Chris, you put it really well that Woods Boss is truly just an amazing community space. And I think we can extrapolate their story to speak to the brewing community as a whole, which is full of wonderful people who want to do good, and they want to drink beer while they do it. And that's why I'm here. Radcraft has been a business for almost a decade, and it started very organically. I am a beer journalist turned publicist. I like to make jokes that I went over onto the dark side. But I was a home brewer in college who was getting a journalism degree, who started freelancing, who became an editor, who wrote a book, and then got asked by a lot of brewers if they could, or if I could help them create complete sentences on their variety of marketing materials. So Radcraft started pretty organically out of the connections that I had in the industry. And to date, we work with Woods Boss as their agency of record. So if you're in the media and you want to learn more about Woods Boss or talk to them, I'm the person you call. And when Jordan put this beer collaboration on my radar, it truly stopped me in my tracks. I was having a little bit of a personal hazy week myself, and I don't know if I'll ever forget that conversation I had with him. He called me up and just spoke to this effort with so much passion that it really helped me just calm down and get present and connect with his passion for this great cause. And a little bit of homework later, and I think the world of what you're doing, Chris, and you, and it's pretty damn awesome to be here. Thanks for letting me be in the green room today, so to speak.
No, it was awesome getting to chat with you. We always love connecting with, you know, anybody. It doesn't matter if you're a brewer, doesn't matter if you're out there every single day, if you're connected to the beer industry, if you like beer, period, that's what we are about. And we are all about, you know, philanthropic causes as well, which is how we got connected with Chris. And Chris, I'm forever indebted to Chris because he gave me the opportunity to be a part of what he's doing. So always appreciate you, man. Radcraft.
No, again, man, right really back at you. I'm thankful that you're a part of it, dude. I'm still stoked that you said hell yeah. And real quick, I just want to say, Emily, I cannot wait to meet you.
I'm so excited. I'm so happy you're coming to Colorado.
Yes, so am I. I really am. I know we kind of played phone tag there for a minute. Unfortunately, I missed you both times, but it's really good. I can see you as well, so it's good to at least see you on screen for now. And then super sonic high fives, you know, the second we were able to finally meet.
Sounds awesome. I'm going to be following you home. I'm going on a road trip down south. So I'm literally following you home. So we will connect.
don't threaten me with a good time.
Yeah.
I'll bring the beer.
That's awesome. Hey, Emily, before you go and before we shut out the show here, I apologize. I didn't realize that you were coming on with us tonight. With that said, reach back out to MASH and let's do an episode with you so you can talk a little bit more about what you do for breweries.
Oh, I would love that. Real quick, and I have a cramp. I gotta stand up. I just jumped in.
Yeah, no worries. But yeah, let's definitely connect with you again and have a show with just you that talks about what you do for breweries and help you trying to get that word out there. We'd love to hear more about it because I'll be honest with you, I struggle with writing complete sentences myself.
It's a North Carolina education. You're all good.
It sounds like you struggle with speaking complete sentences too.
Definitely. Definitely.
Because he's drinking something other than PBR tonight.
Yeah, that I am. Hey, Chris.
I'm flattered. That sounds great. Yeah. Thank you, everybody.
No problem. Chris and Jordan, definitely appreciate having you both on tonight. Man, Chris, it is always a pleasure to have you on and share what it is that you're doing with Bottleshare. I look forward to following that journey some more and look forward to shaking your hand one day and drinking a beer with you as well.
Hell yeah. Likewise, brother. Absolutely. 100%.
Wait.
Jordan, looking forward to it, man. Good luck with the process. Always cool to hear about new breweries up and coming, and especially guys like you that are doing good things, man. That is, to me, that is what breweries are all about. If you want to be sustainable, you got to be giving back and involved in the community, and that whole mission and that what you're doing, Larry, with Bottleshare is just a testament to what you guys are doing. So appreciate your time tonight and what you're doing with Chris as well.
Jordan, offline, will definitely, I can Venmo you if we can get some of the liquid gold.
I'll just send you some fucking beer, dude. Don't worry.
Oh, man, appreciate that. I'm wicked stoked. I really, really appreciate y'all got that.
Yeah, for sure. Well, he can definitely take care of you if we can get some to try. That'd be great. Hey, appreciate everybody.
Pony Express, because I'm not legally allowed to send it to the mail.
No, we don't do it. We're going to hand deliver it.
We don't ever do that on this podcast.
What happens is Chris is going to actually fly to Idaho, hand deliver it, and then he's going to get back on the plane and fly away.
All of you probably know a brewer who's going to be at CBC. Tell them to come by. They can put it in their checkout bag and bring it to you.
Hey,
for sure.
Perfect.
For sure. Let's go.
But one last thing. Anyone else who's in the brewery world, like, get with Bottleshare. Do good works wherever you are, locally, nationally, globally. I don't give a fuck what it's all about.
I love you, dude.
Awesome, Jordan. Hey, along with your parting shots, where can people find you on social media and Woods Boss Brewing?
Oh, fuck. I don't know. I make the beer, man.
I can tell you they're on Facebook and Instagram, Woods Boss Brewing.
Yeah, so woodsbossbrewing.com is our website. We're on Facebook. We're on Instagram. I don't think we twaddle. What's the...
Nope, there's no Twitter. There isn't. Because I run Bottleshare's Twitter, and I've tried to tag you guys, and I'm like, fuck, I can't find them.
I'll put you in touch with Joe, and maybe we'll do something. I don't know. It doesn't matter. The best way is come into the brewery and ask for me.
Nice. I love it. I love it. Jordan, appreciate you joining us.
The crazy thing is that the first time I visited Jordan, he's not kidding when he says that, because there are people constantly going in and out of that brewery all day long, just coming to hang out, chill, and talk with Jordan. It was fascinating.
He's like, "God damn, guys, I'm trying to brew the beer. Come on."
It's really hard to get anything done.
Back off.
If you're gonna talk, if you're gonna stand here and talk, at least help me.
That's how the shadow program actually
started. That's how the shadow program started.
Chris, parting shots,
Dad,
and where can...
Bye, guys.
Yeah, hey, man.
Thanks, man.
Thanks for joining us. Chris, what are your parting shots, and where can people find you and learn more about Bottleshare?
Yeah, absolutely. So, real quick, for those that don't know about Bottleshare, as you've heard, my name is Christopher Glenn. I used to be the bar manager at Dry County Brewing Company in Kennesaw, Georgia. One night after closing up the brewery, I was on my way home, and I was struck by a drunk driver. It resulted in permanent neurological damage. And if it wasn't for my friends, my family, and the craft beer community who came together, rallied, and fundraised for me, I would either be homeless or dead. That's the only two logical options. You might have heard me say it before, because I say it all the time, but I'm so thankful for it. And that's why I continue to say it. And that's why Bottleshare was born, through the love, through the compassion, through the help of those through the craft beer community. And in that time, I almost started harboring feelings of guilt, because I was wondering, why was I provided with an optimal environment to heal when so many others don't have that? They don't have that family. They don't have that team, that support system. And so Bottleshare is really becoming just that. You know, we want to be that team. We want to be that support system for you when you're down, when things seem like they, you know, can't get any freaking worse. And when things seem like they can't get any freaking better, that's when we want to step in and provide the services that we provide. So with that being said, you can find us on our website, www.thebottleshare.org. You can find us on Twitter at Bottleshare1. And then you can find us on Instagram and Facebook, Bottleshare Official. That's where you can find us. Come and hang out. It's a journey. The journey is becoming an adventure. We like to document everything. I personally as well like to document everything. The good, the bad, the ugly, you're going to see it all. I still go into these episodes probably every 6 to 8 weeks, where I'm out for 2 weeks. I'll sleep for 48 hours straight, wake up, grab something to drink, quick bite to eat, and go back to sleep. My brain just literally shuts down. And you'll see that too. I want to be as honest, open, and vulnerable about this entire journey as I possibly can, so that people that are a part of it, people that join us, people that follow and support, they are, I don't want to say educated, but they see and they know and they experience everything that's behind the story that is Bottleshare.
Gives it genuineness.
Hell yeah. I couldn't think of a better person to do a bigger job.
I just want to hug you right now, man. Like, I can't wait till we can bro hug. Just like embrace.
It's going to
be like the biggest embrace that anybody has ever seen.
I like what he said, supersonic high five. I want a supersonic high five.
Yeah, honestly.
Yeah. Chris, appreciate you joining us again tonight, man. Looking forward to sharing a beer with you one day.
Likewise, my friend. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah. Brewitch, parting shots. What do we have to look forward to? I know you're maybe moving, possibly, but probably not. What's the word?
I'm going to be moving at some point. I don't know when, but like, I need to start planning it soon. So, eventually back to maybe Ireland, but to be determined. I need to find work. So that's like the main goal, and then we'll figure it out. So I'll be going at some point, but I'll be here probably through the end of the month. Otherwise, they...
Idaho before you leave.
I don't even know how to get to Idaho. Like, flights there. Like, how does one get there?
It's like going to Mordor. Nobody actually knows.
So like, I'll be around...
Oregon Trail, right?
Yeah, honestly, I'll get my like horse and buggy ready, and I'll be on the road
on the way
in 4 months.
Yeah. Ask for this.
Still have dysentery.
Yeah.
Yeah, honestly. So like, Otherwise, not loads going on. There's a new tap room opening tomorrow in Chicago that I would love to check out. I'm not sure if I'll be able to go tomorrow, but hopefully I'll be there sometime soon. It's in the Lincoln Square neighborhood, which I love. There's loads of stuff around there. It's just called the Lincoln Square Tap Room. But they're supposed to have 1.5 million local beers on tap. So if anyone is in Chicago this weekend, look it up. Maybe they're pouring. See what's going on. Otherwise, I hopefully should write some more articles. To be determined as usual. Do not expect any prompt stuff from me. That's all I got to say.
What I really appreciate about you is the honesty.
Yeah, yeah.
It'll maybe come sometime.
Kind of suck. I'm going to do it, but it kind of sucks, so I'll get there.
I love
you'll get there, and y'all will be thrilled, and you're welcome, so
but
that's
when you
all.
Do articles, they're always very well thought out and researched, even when they're just shower beers. You research the shit out of shower beers.
Did I research or did I drink in the shower?
That's research.
So, yeah, thank you. That's very nice of you. Like, who knows what, like, dynamite topic I'll pull out.
Wild card.
Like, throw me your ideas. Like, you tell me, please.
Awesome.
So, to be determined.
Looking forward to whatever it is, Brew. And good luck with your decisions, for sure.
Thank you.
Mash, parting shots, and what do we have to look forward to?
Parting shots. Go Pack Go, first and foremost. Second of all, though, so we just dropped our Shang-Chi movie review over on Geeks. Lauren and I did. We both saw it. We went to the movies. It was crazy. It was wild. Best top 5 Marvel movie of all time. Anyways, Batman episode's going to come out next week. This year it's coming out. I got a good feeling about this one. I did a lot of research, and last year our audio got deleted. So this year, by God, if I have to walk it to the server myself, it's coming out. And other than that, I'm still waiting. We're getting on some promotion things. I just hung out at Woodland Empire last Friday. Got to do a little bit of the canning action. That was a lot of fun. And we're going to be brewing beer together here soon. My beer is fermenting as I throw my highlighter. Sorry, that was what that noise was. My beer is fermenting. It's a pumpkin maple coffee stout, and that's going to be done here in a few weeks. I'm hoping that it comes out and I can get a bottle to everybody here. And Geeks is rolling along. Follow us on Bottle Share. I work with Chris, so I tell you guys every single week, make sure you're checking out Bottle Share and what's going on there, because I can't truly describe what it means to me to really work with Chris and be a part of that organization. That's all I've got.
Awesome. Looking forward to the Geeks contact, man.
I love being here.
Let's go check in with Hoppy. Hoppy, parting shots. What do we have to look forward to?
My parting shots, Matt summed it up pretty well. The Shang-Chi was amazing. I'm looking forward to our Batman coming out, and we're recording Doom Patrol tonight, so that'll be coming out in like a week and a half to get in preparation for season 3. So that's awesome. I did want to comment. So Patrick posted in the chat section on Facebook that he thinks Bottle Share should start a subscription service that you can get all their collabs.
I think that's a spectacular idea.
Mm.
So yeah, sign me up. But yeah, that's about it.
Yeah, that'd be pretty awesome.
I just need to get in touch with the right distributors.
Oh yeah, and you need to come to Florida too.
We'll make it happen.
You need a Florida collab.
I do. I've been working on it.
Nice. Hey, check us out, Hops News. You can find Hops News anywhere. But before we do, I think Emily, yes, Emily's still there. Emily, we don't have you on video still, but parting shots, and where can people find you?
Heck yeah.
I'm assuming parting shots, because this is my first time here, is just like last words.
Yes. Sure. Might be like your last meal.
Oh my goodness. Well, there's got to be plenty of beer at that table if it's my last meal. So if you are going to be in Denver for the Craft Brewers Conference this week, be safe. Please track down some beers made with craft malt. And no matter where you are, try to track down beers made with local ingredients. I am a big nerd for craft malt, but I think that no matter where you are, you can find something that represents the terroir of where you're from. So that's my parting shot. And you can find us at Radcraft Beer on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and at radcraftbeer.com.
Love it.
Awesome.
Make sure you have my Bottle Share email, since we're in that thread. Make sure we hook up and we get you back on this to talk more, for sure.
That sounds awesome. Yeah, I actually used to stop in Mountain Home quite a bit because I went to the University of Oregon and I'm from Colorado, so I did a lot of driving back and forth. So I do know how to get to you, so maybe we can...
See, somebody does. Look at that. We have somebody who knows where I am. Look, I'm not here by choice. I am not here by choice. Like, I will make that very clear.
Emily, I'm just going to warn you now, you're never going to get rid of MASH now. He's going to be attached to you like a little brother.
Guys, she knows where I am. This place exists. I promise you it's real.
All right.
I get it. I live in a small town too, so we'll drink some beers.
For sure. Parting shots, beat Miami. We'll be in Miami Saturday morning. Gonna be in Miami.
Mexico's coming to Boise for the home opener Friday. Let's go.
Nice. Be some more college football coming up this week. Looking forward to that. Hey, you can find Hops News wherever the podcast platforms are that you listen to, on all your social medias at Hops News. Check us out there. Go check out Lucky's episode. You're going to get play by play. You're going to learn about Lucky finding a campground just out of random and throwing up a hammock and going to sleep overnight. Saturday night. So go listen to their adventures. It's a great episode. Talk to Lucky and
single again.
Yeah, talk to Lucky and Marty and Boonshine. We had a great time at Boonshine. Boonshine was very welcoming for us. So thanks to those guys for letting us stop in, grab a beer, and record an episode. Hey, have a great night. Appreciate everybody joining. Cheers. Till next time.
Cheers,
everyone.
Appreciate y'all.
Thank you.
That's a wrap.
Lauren, I sent you the link, by the way. I just got to go find a beer and go to the bathroom.
All right. My kitchen's suddenly full of kids, so
that's
fine.
Okay. Take a few. I do. I can't take forever because Carrie has homework, but I do have to go find a beer.
Okay, that's fine.
Chris, right. Emily, thank you guys for hanging out with us. Yeah. Annie, always a pleasure.
Yeah.
See you later, guys.
Will you show up next time? Who knows? To be determined.
Thank you so much.
Also, I mean, I definitely won't be next time, so I'll see you maybe in 2 weeks.
All right, well,
we'll find out.
Yo, I was having some killer leg cramps. I lifted legs today, and like, I didn't drink enough water afterwards and started drinking beer, and then I was like dying, and that's what that was about, Lauren. I saw your face.
I know. I saw you right away, and I saw you now, so I knew.